Good morning, friends. In previous chapter and in previous period, we were learning about changes. And I told you the first change, natural and man-made. We have seen some related examples also. Now you can classify, if I give you some examples, you can classify them as natural and man-made changes, right? Now, we will see further classification. Let us see, before telling you, let me give you some examples. Sharpening a pencil. Cooking a food. Baking a bread. These are some examples, and if you see, these all examples are useful to us. We sharp pencil for our use, we cook food to eat, we bake bread for eating. So these all examples are very useful to us. So we can say that these are useful changes, because these all changes happen for our use. We use them properly. Correct. Now the opposite of useful is harmful. Some changes are harmful. For example, falling a tree. If a tree suddenly falls in front of you, you may get hurt. So this is a very harmful change for you, right? So useful and harmful changes. So second is useful and harmful change. If the examples are given, you can classify them into useful and harmful changes. Now next is, let me give you example. Bursting a balloon. Bursting a balloon. And second example is curdling of milk. Let us compare these two examples. By comparing these two examples, we will see that the time taken or the duration of a time for both the changes is different. How it is different? Bursting a balloon, what time it will take to burst a balloon? A very short time, right? So bursting a balloon, it takes short time. In a short time, we can burst a balloon. But for a curdling of milk, we have to keep that milk overnight. Means the process is, it doesn't take short time, it takes a long time. So curdling of milk takes a long time. So here, what we will consider? We will consider the time taken by a change to happen. So if it takes a short time, it is said as quick change. And a change which takes more time to happen, it is slow change. So this is the third example. Till now we have seen natural and man-made change, useful and harmful change, quick change and slow change, right? Now, in earlier class, I have told you, if you take ice cube, it will slowly turn into water, right? So because of temperature, ice turns into water. Means, if you give heat to ice, it will be converted into water. If the heat is taken away, the water again will convert into ice. So this change, we can reverse it. We can reverse the change. That's why it is called as reversible change. But if wood is burnt, If you burn a wood, it will get converted into ash. And from that ash, we cannot recover wood again. So it is irreversible change. So again, we get another kind of changes, reversible and irreversible. The next change is periodic and non-periodic. You know what period is? Some changes occur again and again after some interval of time. For example, day and night, or rising of sun and setting of a sun. It takes a particular time. After a particular time, this process happens again and again. So this kind of change is periodic change. But some changes you cannot say accurately ki after that particular time it will happen again. For example, storm. Storm doesn't occur every day. It may take time of months, year or 10 years. After this, storms happen, earthquake, non-periodic change. Okay, tsunami, non-periodic change. But some changes, they take a particular interval. It is called as periodic change. And the changes which don't have a specific time to happen, they are called as non-periodic changes. So up till now, we have seen this A, B, C, D, E. In next period, we will see physical and chemical changes. Now, students, if an example is given to you, you can classify it as natural, useful, quick, reversible, periodic, man-made, harmful, slow, irreversible, and non-periodic. For example, sharpening a pencil. This is one example given. Let us see from the first, is it natural or man-made? You know, we sharp pencil, right? So it is man-made. So from first group, we have chosen man-made. From second, is it useful or harmful? It is useful for us. So it is useful. It is quick or slow? It's a slow change. It is reversible or irreversible? Once a pencil is sharpened, we cannot unsharp it, right? So it is irreversible. It is periodic or non-periodic? There is no specific time. We sharp a pencil as per our need, right? So it is non-periodic. Got it? So if the examples are given, you can classify them under these groups. Please go through your textbook, that lesson particularly. While reading it properly, see this video, and if you have any doubt, you can ask me on the group. Okay?